Loving God, who chose the mother of your Son to be our mother also, grant us that, persevering in penance and prayer for the salvation of the world, we may further more effectively each day the reign of Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, their descendants shall be renowned among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them should acknowledge them as a race the Lord has blessed. I rejoice heartily in the Lord. In my God is the joy of my soul. For he has clothed me with a robe of salvation, and wrap me in a mantle of justice. Like a bridegroom adorned with a diamond, like a bride bedecked with her jewels, as the earth brings forth its plants, and a garden makes its growth spring up, so will the Lord God make justice and praise spring up before all the nations. The word of the Lord. Listen to me, God, see and bend your ear.
Listen to me, daughter, see and bend your ear.
Hear, O daughter, and see, turn your ear. Forget your people in your father's house. So shall the king desire your queen, for he is your Lord, and he must worship you.
Listen to me, daughter, see and bend your ear.
All glorious is the king's daughter as she enters. Her raiment is threaded with spun gold. In embroidered apparel, she is born into the king. The hybrid of riches of her train are brought to you. They are born in with gladness and joy. They enter the palace of the king. The place of your fathers, your sons shall have. You shall make them princes through all the land.
Listen to me, daughters, see and bend your ear.
Forever. In his kingdom there will be no end. But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" The angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, when I say praise be Jesus Christ, the answer is now and forever. Praise be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Maligayang piyesta. At maligayang pagdiriwang ng parwa. Brother Ray. There is a word that I would like to share with you, a word that weaves three reflections. And the word I'd like to share with you on this auspicious occasion is the word plan. It's a monosyllable word, plan. First reflection of the plan, that is the gospel. The gospel of the Annunciation is part of a great master plan of God, which started in Genesis chapter 3, verse 15. We call that the proto-evangelium, the first proclamation of the gospel. John 3:15 speaks of the one who will crush the head of the serpent, and the serpent who will do everything in his power to bite the heel of the son. Yes, we call chapter 3 of Genesis the chapter of the fall, but little do we know that God works in subtle ways that in the 15th versicle, we discover something so precious that God does not allow us to be damned. God does not allow us to lose paradise. That is why the plan unfolds. And the plan unfolds that in the history of salvation, in different events of the life of Israel, the chosen people, God made his promise truly his own. A promise fulfilled, a plan slowly unfolding before the very eyes of humanity who did not recognize God's visitation. The plan. And the plan found its climax in Nazareth with a humble maiden known as Miriam. This young lady, daughter to Joachim and Anne, chosen from the very beginning, conceived without original sin, is indeed blessed, for she symbolizes a humanity redeemed and renewed, a humanity close to the heart of God, for she has become the tabernacle of the incarnate Word. For in Jesus is the covenant between God and people, then the covenant needed the ark, and the ark is Miriam, the plan. Israel did not recognize God's visitation. That is why there is no room in the inn. That is why people rejected him. That is why he is often called the sign of contradiction. And the woman who bore him stood beneath the cross, suffering pain and wounded, rejected. And yet continuously she said her fiat till the end. The plan. That is what the gospel today talks about. The Annunciation of the Lord simply underlines one precious reality, that God initiates covenants with us. The question is, how disposed are we to the ways of God? How cooperative are we that the church and her children can say, fiat, your will be done. Second reflection, the plan of God in Fatima. In 1917, Our Lady appeared to three shepherd children. But please take note, let us take this as part of a trajectory of men's concern for humanity. That while she is the symbol and the expression of the best in humanity, redeemed and renewed, her love for us, humanity, has never dwindled. Why? Because Fatima needed to be part of the trajectory of the apparitions of Our Lady. In Banu, in Bahrain, in Nob, in Nazareth, in Guadalupe, in Lourdes. And continuously, she has expressed herself, the same kind of message that we read in the Gospel of Jesus Christ. And what is the message? Three words. C-O-R. What is the message of Our Lady? So that we are disposed to God's plan. The first is conversion. Mary never tires to call her children, be converted in my Son, Jesus Christ. Go back to the heart of my Son. Conversion is the way of the gospel. If not, a most important pillar of the new evangelization. Second is offertory. Oh, offertory of what? Offertory of sacrifices? Yes. Offertory of masses, celebration of the Eucharist? Yes. Offertory of adoration of the Blessed Sacrament? Yes. Offertory of confessions and encounter with Jesus in the Sacrament of Reconciliation? Yes. Offertory of one consecrating oneself to her Immaculate Heart every first Saturday? Yes. Offertory. Do these things because we are children of one woman whose yes has never been diminished. And the last letter is R, which is reparation. Reparation. Reparation of wrongs that have been done against Jesus, against the most blessed sacrament. The inability of people to understand the ways of God. Repair that. And reparation is simply expressed in getting to know Jesus more. Into the I-Thou relationship necessary for Jesus to reign supreme in the hearts of men and women. Reparation. Jesus is not known because he is not loved. Repair that. She asked us. You know, Fatima has a distinctive mark. Fatima has three secret messages. What are the three secret messages opened by Our Lady to the three children? First secret message is hell. It frightened Francisco and Jacinta. Frightened them so that after the apparition, they offered their lives so that souls would not be damned in hell. It frightened, especially Jacinta. Oh, she was so concerned about that in her biography, that they offered her lives so that souls would not be thrown into the fiery furnace of hell. Because she saw hell. And there many souls damned in hell. Yes, hell is real. It is eternal damnation. It is fire. It is condemnation. It is not being loved forever. as a frightening prospect. That is the first secret of Fatima. And what is the second secret of Fatima? The second secret of Fatima are the two world wars, World War I and World War II, and the destruction that these world wars will bring about humanity. Expression of what? Pius XII says it well. The greatest tragedy of the century is the loss of the sense of sin. World War I and World War II are simply expressions of what? The loss of the sense of sin. Let me add, the loss of the sense of sin is due to the loss of the sense of conscience. And the loss of the sense of conscience is due to the loss of the sense of God. By sin or syllogism, therefore, the greatest tragedy of the century is the loss of the sense of God. But isn't that the age that we are living in now? Postmodernism to post-truth, the context in which we find ourselves. In schools, colleges, and universities, and techetical ministries are challenged to face a sense of being people, a people marginalizing God with our obsession to excellence. We have lost the sense of what? Spirituality. A danger, dear brothers and sisters, that while you learn the rubrics of management and administration and leadership, never lose sight that you are first and foremost men and women of deep spirituality. If you lose that, you simply run offices as technocrats, and you lose the sense of the God who visits us in most surprising ways. Third secret, only open during the term of John Paul II. You know when it was open? When he was shot on May 13, in 1981. When he was almost killed by the bullet of Mehmet Ali Abka, a Turkish sharpshooter. It is said that an unseen hand diverted the bullet so that the bullet would not hurt the vital organs of the Pope. While recuperating at Gemelli Hospital, according to the biography, according to the story, John Paul II called his closest cardinal advisors, requested Cardinal Ratzinger to open two important documents. Number one, the Diary of Faustina. With regards to divine mercy, read. And second, open the Diary of Lucia and the testimonies of the three children on the third secret of Fatima. Why? Because the third secret of Fatima talks about great persecution in the church, culminating in the death of the Pope. The Holy Father responded to the reports of Cardinal Ratzinger in two ways. Number one, he went to Regina Celi prison and there reached out in reconciliation to his would-be-assassin, Mehmet Ali Abka. Nobody knew what transpired, but you can see the pictures brought to us by Time Magazine and Newsweek, the smiles of these two people, close to each other, whispering. In the end, enemies became friends. A result of what? The divine mercy. Second response of John Paul. John Paul II went on pilgrimage to Fatima and brought with him the bullet that almost killed him. gaze at the crown of Our Lady, the pilgrim statue now bears the bullet that almost killed the successor of Saint Peter. All throughout these years, John Paul II has been a devout Catholic, from Czestochowa to Lourdes to Fatima to Guadalupe, and there always seeking the protection of Mary. Our Lady. Part of God's plan? Yes. Third and last reflection. Your plan. That is our work today. Let us be disposed to God's plan. Amen. You may have learned so many things these past days, but I will use them as a point as we look at these great works of the Somos, and simply say, looking at the crucifix, everything is strong to the great mystery before us. Primacy of grace. Beloved colleagues, it's a phrase used by John Paul in Novo Milenio Eniunte. The primacy of grace. Na hindi magiging matagumpay ang anumang plano kung wala ang dasal, kung wala ang buhay kapatalan, kung wala ang araw-araw na pakipagdiin at pakipagbunod sa Santisimo Sacramento sa lupa, kung wala ang misa, kung wala ang mga oras na katahimikan na doon lang tayo nakatingin sa binabay ng buhay at sinasabi natin sa Kanya, kayo na po ang bahala sa aking dalaw, sa aking mga problema, sa aking mga dinadala, sa aking magiging tagumpay, sa aking paumuna, kayo na po